doing two monologues today. The first, Quiche Isn't Sexy by Gabriel Davis, and the second one is Like Dreaming Backwards by Kelly Powell. Quiche isn't sexy. I think people who eat quiche are pretentious. It's not that I don't appreciate that you made this for me, I just think quiche is pretentious. It's an egg trying to be more than a breakfast food. When you think eggs, do you think romance? You could have made a rack of lamb. Rare, wonderful. We'd start with our forks and knives, take small bites. Soon those little bites would turn into bigger bites, and then we'd have the lamb bones in our hands and we'd be devouring them, and then we'd devour each other. No, I don't mean literally, I mean sexually. You devour me sexually, I devour you sexually. Yes, it sounds weird out loud, but it wouldn't feel weird. I'd love to be devoured by a man who cooks wonderful lamb. You look uncomfortable. Good food should be devoured. Great sex should be delicious and impossible not to devour. You start towards each other slow, but a something drives you to go faster and faster till you're covered in flesh and juices, but you don't care because, well, because you're not eating a quiche. Suddenly you realize that you're dreaming, and you realize if you know that you're dreaming, you can control what happens next. When I have an episode, it's exactly like that, only backwards. The first time I tried to kill myself, I was 10. When I woke up in the morning, I was relieved. I was happy I hadn't succeeded. Then, a year later, I tried again. I've lost count of how many times I have tried and failed. I've tried to poison myself, overdose on sleeping pills, hang myself, drown myself, suffocate myself, and throw myself into traffic. Now, when I wake up after swallowing every sleeping pill in sight and washing it down with a bottle of wine, I never, ever feel relieved. I feel trapped. I feel desperate. I feel like even more of a failure. And I've even thought, what if the reason I can't kill myself is because I'm already dead and in hell? This is living hell. They say suicide is taking the easy way out. Let me tell you, it's not that easy. Your body's physical drive to live undermines your mind's desire to die. Your instincts to breathe are hard to overcome, and you can't take another second of misery. But your heart just refuses to stop.